Hello there, you amazing viewers and subscribers. Welcome to a brand new Star Trek review for today. So in this review, I'm going to be reviewing my all-time favourite Star Trek movie. And this is better than The Wrath of Khan. And it is better than The Undiscovered Country. It is Star Trek First Contact, the second Next Generation movie. And it is my all-time favourite Star Trek movie. So what can I tell you about this? So of course it has the crew of the Enterprise D, apart from Mr. Worf, who is on board Deep Space Nine, but he does join the Enterprise D later on in this film. So we have a brand new Enterprise, aka the Sovereign Enterprise, which is known as the Enterprise E, and it was launched in 2372. Because this year, in this movie, is actually set in the year 2373, on stardate 50893.5. Now, this is where Captain Picard is there having a dream version about him being assimilated by the Borg that happened in Star Trek The Next Generation episode The Best of Both Worlds, which actually happened on the start in between star dates 43989.1 and 44001.4. So Captain Picard is there having nightmares about him being assimilated by the Borg in that episode, and then it comes up to a message from Deep Space from Star Trek Command Center. There's been a report from Deep Space 5, and Picard goes, "Yes, I know. The Borg." Now, the Borg, when we encounter them, are in this Borg cube, and it's above Earth. So when you see the Battle of Section 001, with the Defiant and other Federation starships attacking this Borg cube, but the Enterprise-E comes in and fires quantum torpedoes straight to the hull after Captain Picard takes command of the fleet. And then while the cube is there blowing up, the Borg sphere shoots out and opens up a time portal to go back to 2363 to try and stop First Contact. But of course, our all-time famous captain and the crew of the Enterprise-E travel back in time to stop the Borg from killing Saffron Cochrane and stopping First Contact. In a way, when the Borg arrive, they are literally straight away attacking the area Saffron Cochrane is building his warp ship, aka the Phoenix. So the Enterprise-E comes out, Picard sees it, but not even realizing he's got no shields, fires, the Borg sphere blows up, but the Borg end up transporting up onto the Enterprise-E. So then for the rest of the Star Trek film, it's all set in the Enterprise-E, or down on Earth with Saffron Cochrane, while he's building the Warp 5 ship. Well, the Warp ship, aka the Phoenix. I would say Warp 5, but that was really the NX-01, I suppose. I kind of got a bit headed there myself. Now, in this movie, it's the very first time we see the appearance of the Borg Queen. Now, for some reason, during a flashback scene, which we didn't see in The Next Generation, Captain Picard became very aware of the Borg Queen when he was assimilated into Locutus, because she wanted him to become her equal. And you know what happens. Yeah, I'm not saying more than that. So Also, what happens after Mr. Worf joins the team? I absolutely love Mr. Worf when they're there, like trying to remove the reflector dish to stop the Borg from sending a signal to the 20th century Borg. So when they use the reflector dish to send a signal, Mr. Worf goes, "Assimilate this." Now, this is where Captain Picard delivers his great line, where he goes, "I will not sacrifice the Enterprise. We made too many compromises already, too many retreats. They invade our space. And we fall back, destiny left in time of worlds, and we fall back. Not again, the line must be drawn here, this far, no further. And I will make them pay for what they've done." So this is where Captain Picard shows off his true anger against the Borg and what they did to him to kill 39 starships at the Battle of War 359. Now again, this is another one of my all-time favourites, because this is where we see the Borg do something a lot more. They kidnap Lieutenant Commander Data, they give him blood in his arms, his face and stuff. So Mr. Data is actually an android. Now, if you haven't seen Star Trek First Contact, I recommend this Star Trek film, because I absolutely love First Contact. It is my all-time favourite Star Trek movie. Patrick Stewart is amazing as Captain Picard in this. You got Brent Spiner as brilliantly as Mr. You got Alison King, who's really, really good as the Borg Queen. Again, you have Zefon Crocrin with the Enterprise crew down on Earth. And this is the first time we actually see Captain Picard order the evacuation of the Enterprise. So he can actually activate the self-destruct. Which basically becomes a bit rubbish because Data stops the self-destruct. But Data then goes and hits the plasma inside engineering. And then you kind of see the Borg Queen's face all melt off. And the Borg drones are there blowing up and stuff. And then Captain Picard gets the crew of the Enterprise and they open a portal after they've literally just watched first contact between humans and the first alien species, which are the Vulcans. When you see them coming, he goes, "Live long and prosper." And Zefon Crocrin's like, they're going, "Yeah, let's just handshake." And they're like that. Now, I love it when Picard goes back to the Enterprise and the Enterprise goes back to the 24th century and you got Zefon Crocrin there playing his music going and he goes, no, just relax. And, goes, and then he's there dancing. You go, wiggle to the left, wiggle to the right. I absolutely love that scene, the ending scene of First Contact. So that's a bit of stuff from First Contact. Now, for my actual proper review, this Starship film will always be one of my favourite Trek films. It is amazing and absolutely a blast to sit down to enjoy and keep rewatching. Now, when I first watched it, now the thing is, this film came out in 1996 in November. So in this November, this film becomes 25 years old. I was born at like back in May in 1996, and this film came out in theaters back in 1996 in November. This Star Trek film is the same age as me, and I absolutely love that because I got a same age and the same age as Doctor Who the movie and same age as Star Trek First Contact. Also, some episodes of Deep Space Nine I'm the same age as. What about season 4 and 5 in between? I absolutely do love Star Trek First Contact. Captain Picard, aka played by Patrick Stewart, gives a great performance. He goes, "I will not sacrifice the Enterprise. We've made too many compromises already, too many retreats. They invade our space and we come back. They select attack the worlds and we come back. Not again. The line must be drawn here. This far, no further. And I will make them pay for what they've done." I absolutely do love that line. And I love the bit in the holodeck as well where Picard stops the safety protocols and he deactivates them. And he's there with this proper machine gun and just shooting the bug going, "Ah! Ah!" And then you have that woman, Lily, go, "Stop! I think you got him." And then she goes, "Oh, Jean-Luc, it's one of your uniforms." Now, I absolutely love this film because, one, Captain Picard and the crew of the Enterprise disobeys the order from Starfleet. They told him to stay in the neutral zone to scan to certain cases the Romulans take advantage. But Captain Picard ends up disobeying and points the ship into maximum warp to get back to Sector 001. So it's like that, and they go, like that. I absolutely love the Enterprise Aid of Software. This is the very first time the Enterprise Age is actually introduced in Star Trek. It is a great Enterprise. I mean, 24 decks, whatever. How many decks it is by the time it gets to it. I mean, look at it. The Enterprise E, the Suffering class. And I like the way you got the nose like pointing down. So when it fires on the Borg vessel, it goes round and you got the Borgs, like the Borg cube, and it goes, and then there's wheels. I absolutely do love Star Trek First Contact. It is one of the best Star Trek films of all time, and I have to say that. So, let me know in the comments what you think of Star Trek First Contact. Is it one of your favourite Star Trek films as it is one of mine? Let me know and enjoy the rest of the day and fantastic. And thank you for being fantastic viewers, fantastic subscribers. Thank you for watching, and please join me in another Star Trek video at some point. So, I'm going to sit here with my mother, the Enterprise E. And I'm going to go engage. See you next time.